Hey guys, welcome back to a new video, guys. Happy Monday, which means a boring Monday, like Garfield says. And today, guys, we'll be checking out Backrooms Damage Control. Make sure you go subscribe to the Pixel channel down below. And this was made today, by the way, and I'm pretty much sure this is pretty gonna be scary. So before we get started, guys, make sure you go subscribe to my channel, by the way, hit the notification bell down below. And as always, you ready? Let's get it. Come on, light, dang it. I hate how it doesn't work for me sometimes. That's just really confusing. I'll get this. Oh, what the heck? The blood. I saw the guy's warning. Pretty Oh! Fuck. Jump scare yet. We're still good.
Address what occurred without running into speculation.
I don't blame you all. I don't blame you. Oh.
So that is all close to common knowledge, I presume. Not all of you were with us at the time. Jeez. However,
that would be fairly inappropriate. No, I meant cancer.
Regardless, that was where Tenshu's involvement in this came to an end. Or at least that's what we assumed. Because on May 8th at approximately 5:30 p.m., a motion alert was sent out from the complex, which was closed off at the time. One of our senior engineers was sent down to assess the situation and discovered a male dressed in hazard gear who we were able to identify as Peter Tench. Immediately following this discovery, Tench was moved to secure rooms for the following days. A select group of doctors were able to administer a panel of tests in order to determine what had happened to Peter in the 2 months he had been gone. Those tests yielded very little useful information. By all measures, Peter appeared to be in excellent health. However, we were still provided one very useful tool in understanding how the situation unfolded from his perspective. Some of you may recall that on the day of his disappearance, Tench was his team's designated camera operator. Well, when we recovered him, he still had that camera in his possession. And, in fact, had documented the entire ordeal. The footage will be presented in its entirety later today. However, for the purpose of this discussion, I will only be highlighting key events. This is the hallway where Peter was last seen. They're not in view, but you can hear the others walking behind him. Now, as he approaches the burn to the right here, pay close attention to the audio.
Dad, can you hear this?
Now, I'd like to save the discussion for afterwards, but what you just saw is what we believe to be the moment that Peter was instantaneously transported 2 months forward in time. Following that abrupt flash you just saw, Tench proceeds back out into the hallway in search of his team, but is without any indication of the presence. The next 30 or so minutes of the tape follow a fairly panicked Tench as he attempts to navigate his way back to the threshold. He does obviously find his way back. However, the threshold appears not as he knows it, but as it appeared on the date of May 8th. And this ties us back to the moment when we recovered him.
He's co-wed.
So,
co-wed.
To summarize, from
co-freaking wed.
So to him, all of the new developments surrounding the threshold were completely foreign. Luckily, though, as I already mentioned, there were people available to manage the situation as it unfolded. And over the course of the following days, we were able to properly sit down with Peter and work with him to gain a collective understanding of what had happened. However, there was still the very significant fact that Mr. Tench was considered legally deceased as a result of the cover story. Reversing that would be no easy feat. He understood this.
At least he didn't drop a lock in the screen. That would be
unfortunate. Unfortunately, though, that process ended up taking quite a bit longer than
that. Really.
And all the while, and Peter was stuck here waiting.
Keep that in mind. That could be like something like really in pulp.
It is hard to combat the effects of prolonged sensory deprivation on the human brain, and as a result, Peter's mental state took a toll, not to a degree that was outright concerning at first, but around the end of week two, we noticed that he was starting to exhibit a number of behaviors common in patients diagnosed with paranoid schizophrenia, though we don't have reason to believe that Mr. Tench was afflicted with that condition. Whatever the case, while he didn't express it outright, from what we could gather, he appeared to have deluded himself into believing that he was still inside some sort
of... This is just pretty creepy, disturbing story.
And that we were
like, if you know what I mean, This is a really freaking creepy story. You know what I mean. Right? Shoo.
Still held on to the belief that all of us here were working to trap him in some way, despite our actions saying exactly the opposite. Immediately after firing a single shot from the Remington 870 to Dr. Bloom's side, Tench fled the scene and headed to the Threshold outpost, where he returned the weapon on several more of you while progressing into standard and through the lower offices. Given the abrupt and chaotic nature of the unfolding situation, it took our security team several moments longer than it ideally should have to figure out what was happening. But thankfully, while Tench was passing through one of the empty labs next to storage, Dr. Maxwell was able to act quickly and managed to disarm him, accidentally discharging the weapon into the field in the process, though. However, Tench still managed to avoid apprehension, fleeing into the maintenance wing and evading our security staff by taking the freight elevator to the surface. Now, this situation could have played out very badly, given the potential number of witnesses around the building at the time. But, luckily for everyone involved, as far as we can tell, Tench was unnoticed as he exited the property. Around 5 minutes later, our security team made it to the ground floor and began a thorough sweep in the direction of the hillside where cameras had last observed Tench. Now, there's no easy way to say this other than to just say it. I am terribly sorry to inform you all, but Mr. Tench was found deceased halfway down the hillside. The result of an extreme blow to the head. It appears that while he was running through some brush, he failed to anticipate a sudden dip in the ground and tragically fell forward into a large rock. Given the circumstances, it was not something any of us could have anticipated or prevented. The tragedy of the entire situation undoubtedly remains, but Dr. Tench, regardless of how troubled he was in his final days, was a really man who gave his all to this project. He would certainly not want us hindering him in his name. What we're doing here is so much bigger than any one person. It is the work of a unified effort, and we need to ensure that that is never lost sight of. That we hold on to the pre-established notion that Peter is and has been deceased. That is done, and there is nothing more to be extracted.
That was crazy. Is everybody gonna win that foam? Come on, is someone gonna answer that dang phone? Answer the goddamn phone, you piece of shit! Answer the goddamn phone! Answer it! Oh, now you're gonna end it off like that? Okay, so that really makes sense. That's gonna make sense. Well, that was pretty creepy. Actually, that was a really creepy story. It was creepy at the same time and creepy at the same ways of that story. That was pretty creepy. Make sure you go subscribe to him down below, and let's hope no copyrights will get on me to this. And make sure you go subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and I will see you all in the next one. As always, deuces.